We want to demonstrate practically the way it should be done. Part 14, dimension and physics. Dimension is the relationship between physical quantities and fundamental quantity expressed in terms of the symbol of fundamental quantities. We want to examine about 11 quantities. Number one is area of a cube. The derivation of area of a cube, we know that area of a cube is length times area is a length times breadth. But in a cube, the value of length is equal to the value of breadth. So area will be equal to length times length, which is equal to L raised to power 1 times L raised to power 1. This one is equal to L raised to power 1 plus 1, which is equal to L raised to power 2. Number 2 is volume of a cube. As you all know, volume, formula for volume is length times breadth times height. But in a cube, the value of the length is equal to the value of the breadth is equal to the value of the height. So L, volume of a cube be equal to L length times L length times length. This one will give us L raised to power 1 times L raised to power 1 times L raised to power 1, which is the same thing as L raised to power 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is L raised to power 3. L raised to power 2, L raised to power 3. Now, the third one is velocity. Velocity is given by displacement all over time. Displacement, the symbol of displacement is length, and that of time is t. So formula is L over t, or L t raised to power minus 1. That is the dimension of velocity, L t raised to power minus 1. Number 4, speed. Speed is distance over time, and in case of a distance, the distance is represented by L, and time is represented by T. So it will give us L over T, or L T raised to power minus 1. So this speed is also L T raised to power minus 1. And number 5, acceleration is velocity all over time. Acceleration is velocity all over time. Our velocity is L all over T times T. This one gives us LT raised to power minus 2. So we can write it like this: L all over T squared, or L t raised to power minus 2. The next one is momentum. The next one is momentum. Number 6. Momentum, the derivation of momentum is mass times velocity. The physical quantity of mass is m, and that of velocity is L all over T. Therefore, to give us N L T raised to power minus 1. So momentum is N L T raised to power minus 1. Number seven, that is density. That is density. That one is mass over volume. Mass over volume. Physical point of a symbol of a fundamental point is M. Symbol of a fundamental point of a volume is L raised to power 3. So therefore it will be L, L raised to power minus 3. So density is L, L raised to power minus 3. In case of force, we are going to combine, the derivation is a mass and acceleration. This one, the fundamental quantity, the super fundamental quantity of mass is M, and A, acceleration is L. We found that one before, L alpha T raised to power minus 2. So this one will give us M L M L T raised to power minus 2. Nine is pressure. The derivation of pressure is force over area. The fundamental quantity of a force is M L T raised to power minus 2, and that of area is L raised to power 2. So this one will give us M L 1 minus 2 T raised to power minus 2. So this one will give us P is equal to N L raised to power minus 1 T raised to power minus 2. So pressure will be N L raised to power minus 1 T raised to power minus 2. The next one is work. Work. The derivation of work is force times distance. Force is given by M L T raised to power minus 2. Distance is given by L. Therefore, work will be equal to N L T raised to power 2 T raised to power minus 2. Work M L 2 T raised to power minus 2. The last but not the least is power. Power is given by the derivation of work all of our time. And work is equal to N L raised to power 2 T raised to power minus 2 all over T. So P will be equal to N L 2 T minus 2 minus 1. Therefore, power will be equal to N L 2 T raised to power minus 3.